Now let's do a simple example where we will apply the acceleration and velocity relationship that we have just derived for rotating reference frame. So what we will do first is, we'll do a very simple example where we will have a disk which is constrained to rotate about its center, and there is a slot cut in the disk, and inside this slot there is a slider, we'll call it P, that is allowed to slide. Okay, so the very first thing we need to do is to show our reference frames. In fact, I'm going to give you a general method a little bit later, but we can apply our relationship right now. So we need to locate our moving reference frame. Our moving reference frame would be aligned and attached to this disk. So it's rotating with some angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. And this rotating reference frame, shown as small oxy, is our moving or rotating or secondary reference frame. And momentarily, we will also align our fixed reference frame, which is capital O, capital X, and capital Y, which is our fixed or primary frame, again co-aligned with the rotating frame. So OXY, small OXY, is going to rotate as the rigid body or the disk in this case rotates, but capital O, capital X, and capital Y will stay in its place. Okay, so let's first do the velocity analysis. We will say that the distance from O to P is, let's say, R, okay? And its relative velocity in this direction is, let's say, V relative, and its relative acceleration is also along that direction. So we can write velocity of P equal to velocity of O, which is zero because it's a fixed point, plus omega cross R of P, which is to O, which is this vector, and that is nothing but x I hat. Notice how this is a small I hat, lowercase I hat, that indicates this is a unit vector along the small x direction, plus V relative. So this is omega k cross x I hat, and V relative is some magnitude and its direction is positive I hat. So this becomes omega x j hat plus V relative I hat. So the velocity of P, as seen in an inertial or a fixed or a primary reference frame, has two components. One is along x direction, that is due to the sliding, and the other is along j direction, which is omega x. So if I were to show these, this will be the direction of V relative, which we already shown before actually, and this is omega times x, right? So velocity has two components. Now some of you may recognize this as similar to something that you had obtained when you did velocity analysis using polar coordinate system. So in polar coordinate system, you had a radial direction, so that would be er hat this way and e theta hat this way. If we say this is theta, that's increasing direction of theta, and that distance is r, which is same. So in r theta system, velocity was written as r dot er hat plus r theta dot e theta hat. And if you compare these two equations over here, we have r theta dot, which is same as omega x because omega is theta dot, and v relative is nothing but the rate at which r is changing, right? So the rate at which the distance between O and P is changing, so that is same as r dot. So we obtain the same thing. So you may ask, so then why do we need to use, you know, this big relationship over here to do the velocity analysis when we can use r theta system? So yes, for this particular problem, you can definitely use r theta system, but it turns out that when you have a slightly more complicated problem, multiple rigid bodies, multiple rigid motions, then using r theta system may not be a very easy way to solve the problem. So within that case, we will resort to using our relative velocity, relative acceleration equation that we have obtained in this particular module. All right, now let's do the acceleration analysis. So we'll write the acceleration of P, again choosing O as a reference point. We have this minus omega square R of P with respect to O plus alpha cross R of P with respect to O plus 2 omega cross V relative. Let me first write all the terms. And you will notice that I have already introduced a simplification here for omega cross R, which is only valid when rigid bodies move in a plane. So this is zero. We have minus omega square R of P is equal to R I hat plus alpha K cross R I hat plus 2 omega k cross v relative along I direction plus a relative also along I direction, right? Now, if v relative was negative, that would mean that p was actually moving towards the center of O. Okay, so let's collect all the like terms, minus omega squared r, and then we have a relative I hat, so I'll write a relative over here, and thus I hat plus k cross I over here is j, so we get alpha r plus k cross I again is j, so this is 2 omega v relative times j hat. Now let's look at each of these terms. So it turns out again that acceleration has two components, one along I direction, the other along j direction. So along I direction, what are the terms? We have minus omega square r. So minus omega square is pointing this way, thus omega square r. That's towards the center, which we have also seen as normal direction acceleration. We have a relative, that's pointing in the direction of sliding. Alpha r is pointing that way. And then 2 omega v relative is also pointing that way, right? Okay, so just remember that we have v relative and a relative because there is relative motion between O and P, okay? If P was fixed in its place, then we won't have relative velocity and relative acceleration term. In that case, everything would reduce to relating the velocity and acceleration between two points on the same rigid body. Now, let's compare this with acceleration in r theta system. We have r double dot minus r theta dot squared er hat plus 2 r dot theta dot plus r theta double dot e theta hat. So we have a relative. A relative is nothing but r double dot, right? That's the relative acceleration. And you will remember that relative acceleration is basically the acceleration that is measured with respect to a rotating reference frame. So if you were literally standing on this disk, what would you see the distance between yourself and the point P changing as? So the rate at which distance changes gives you r dot, the distance, the second derivative of that distance gives you r double dot, and those are relative velocity and relative acceleration terms. R theta dot squared is same as r omega squared, 2 r dot theta dot is same as 2 omega v relative, and r theta double dot is same as alpha r, right? So the whole idea behind showing you the r theta system acceleration and velocity is to show you that it's not that just because we are doing rigid body kinematics or rigid body dynamics, you know, everything that we did before became invalid. Okay, for simpler cases, things may reduce to simpler scenarios like we saw in this particular example.